Hey everyone, in my previous video, we took an unknown sensor and determined it was an I2C SHTC3 temperature humidity sensor. We learned the commands needed for wake up, sleep, and reading humidity and temperature data. In this video, we'll add support to the Unitemp application for the SHTC3 sensor using what we learned from the previous video. Let's get started. Under application user Unitemp sensors, I've created two files, an SHTC3.h header file and an SHTC3.c implementation file. Sensor.h has an include for the SHTC3 header. In Sensors.c, under the SensorType array at the end of it, I added a reference to the SHTC3 object, which is defined in the header file. On line 23, you can see we have the sensor type SHTC3. At the top of our include, we prevent it from being included multiple times by doing ifndef with the SHTC3 and then defining SHTC3. We pound include unitemp and sensors.h. We define our sensor type as SHTC3. And then we define the methods that will be invoked by the unitemp application. In our SHTC3.c file, we pound include our SHTC3 header. We include the I2C sensor.h file. And then we define all the properties of our SHTC3 sensor type. We define the type name, the alt name, and the interface is I2C. The data type is temperature and humidity. If your sensor supports carbon monoxide or pressure, you'd add that here. Every 1,000 milliseconds, we'll update the temperature and humidity data. When this sensor is chosen, the allocator will get invoked, and then the initializer callback will get invoked. The updater will get invoked to get new temperature data. If the updater fails, the initializer will get invoked again. And then when the application exits or the sensor is removed, the deinitializer and the memreleaser will get invoked. In the current implementation, I'm just logging each method that's getting invoked. In this video, we'll edit those methods to talk to the actual sensor. Again, I recommend you watch the previous video where we walk through the datasheet to understand the commands we're going to send. Okay, so in our I2C alloc, we're not using the args, so we say unused args. We're logging that we've entered the alloc method. From the sensor, we get an instance, which will be an I2C instance. And then we need to set the minimum and maximum I2C address. There's only one address supported, 0x70. So we'll update our minimum to 70, and we'll update the maximum to 70. For more advanced sensors, allocate calibration tables here as well. Next, we have the init method. This gets invoked when the sensor is being used. It will be invoked multiple times, and every time update fails, init will get invoked again. We'll modify this code to do a wake up and then do device ID and log the ID. One word of caution, if you return false, your update method will still get invoked. The wake up command is 3517. So we'll change our data to 3517 and we'll name it data_wakeup. And then we'll write array for 2 bytes with data_wakeup. Read ID register is EFC8. So we'll make a new data_read ID with 2 bytes. And we'll set the data to EFC8. And then we'll do another write array with 2 bytes. And this time with a data read ID for our data. We should get back 2 bytes of data and 1 byte of CRC, so 3 total bytes. And then we'll also update our read array to be 3 bytes. And our log message also needs to only be 3 bytes, so remove the data 3. So we're not doing any validation, but if the reads fail, we'll return false, otherwise we return true. To update the temperature data, we're gonna wanna do the wake up command again, so we'll copy that data wake up, 3517. And then we're gonna wanna write the data out. So we'll copy that, 2 bytes. After a wake up, you should do a delay. So we'll do the for we delay milliseconds for 12 milliseconds. It doesn't really say in the spec how long we should do our delay. It just says to see table 5. And then next we're gonna wanna do clock stretching disabled, read humidity first, F8 E0. We'll make a data humidity temperature variable. It's 2 bytes. And again, that's 58 E0. We'll go ahead and write that data after the delay. And that's data humidity temp. So we'll copy that name, paste it there. And then we'll wait up to 13 milliseconds for that data. We'll go ahead and change the other one to 13 as well. And then we'll read 3 bytes of humidity and 3 bytes of temperature, so 6 bytes total. So we'll do a read array. Copy that line. And then the data. And again, our data is 6 bytes. And so we need to make our read array 6 as well. And then sleep is B098. So we'll go ahead and make a data underscore sleep. And we'll set that to B098. And then don't forget the write array, 2 bytes, data underscore sleep. At this point, our data array has the humidity and temperature data. Copilot's recommending we log it. Seems fine. I'll go ahead and hit save. Reformats the document. Next, we'll create a 16-bit value to store our humidity data. That looks good too. So we take the first byte and shift it 8 bits to the left and then OR it with the next byte. You'll notice temperature is at index 3, not index 2, because we had a CRC in between. Yeah, I don't really care about logging the raw humidity because we already logged the other values. So we'll just skip that. It's auto-generating a humidity formula. Looks close. 100 times the value divided by 2 to the 16. Let's bring up the calculator. We'll switch into scientific. And then we'll do 2 to the power of 16. And that equals 65,536. And Copilot is using 535, so off by just a little bit. Next we'll do temperature. So sensor 175 times our raw divided by 536 minus 45. And it looks like this time the Copilot got the formula correct. Copilot AI always seems like magic to me, but if you're not careful, you will get small bugs. Go ahead and delete those hard-coded values, and then we'll return OK. In our deinit and our free, we just logged messages since we didn't allocate anything. If you do allocate anything, be sure to free it in the free method. Okay, it's demo time, so we'll go Control-Shift-B and say launch app on Flipper. Once it launches, I'll bring up QFlipper. You can see there's currently no sensors added, so go ahead and click the OK button to add a sensor. And then in Sensors.c, we added it to the bottom of the list, so we need to go all the way down to the bottom. And there it is, SHTC3. Click OK. We can see the name. We can see the type. There's a temperature offset. The I squared C address is 70. And we can click on save to save our settings. And it worked, and we're seeing the temperature in Celsius and the humidity. I'll go ahead and touch the sensor and see if we can get it to change a little bit. There we go. So that's really cool. We added a new sensor. Okay, I've closed QFlipper and the app, gone into lab.flipper.net/CLI. We'll type in log. I have debug logging turned on my Flipper. So I'll go ahead and under GPIO, I'll click on the temperature app and launch the application. And there it is. I'm going to click the back button to stop capturing data here. So we can see that alloc was invoked. And then our init was invoked. Then we logged the device ID and the CRC. Init was invoked a second time. Since we hadn't had a successful update, we logged the device ID in the CRC again, and then update was invoked, and then we got the 6 bytes of data. Humidity was the first 2 bytes, followed by a CRC, and then temperature was the next 2 bytes, followed by a CRC. And then every second, update was invoked again, and the screen was updated with the new data. And the back button called deinit, and then it called free. And so there it is, and it's calling our update once a second and updating the screen with the temperature we return and the humidity we return. And again, this application also supports carbon monoxide readings or pressure readings if your temperature sensor has those. I hope you found this video helpful. Please like and subscribe. In the next video, we're going to go ahead and look at what happens if we don't wait long enough on that wake up time. And we're also going to look at clock stretching and understand how clock stretching works. If you have any questions, please leave them below.